Here is a case of right supine PCNL for partial Stegahn calculus in 2 years male baby. We are sharing in this video not how to do PCNL, but what are the problems we faced in supine PCNL, particularly in children. A relatively large stone, RIRS was possible, but ureter was narrow. So patient did not want 3 stages. Patient is also socioeconomically not affordable. So we consider directly supine PCNL, as we are doing most of the cases supine PCNL only. We can see one stone in the pelvis. At the same time, this is the middle calyx I am puncturing. Inferior calyx was not getting delineated. And because it is clear urine, we proceeded with dilatation. The important thing we want to share is here is that when we do dilatation, the kidney moves a lot except the initial dilatation. The ureter, see this dilator, when it is going inside, exactly at the level of the kidney, even though it is superficial, see, I am using my left hand severely. In the C-arm, this was moving heavily. This is a major problem in supine PCNL. So the kidney is moving almost to the opposite side of the spine. So that is, see this, how it is moving. Even with minimal dilatation, so supine PCNL, we observe is, the movement of the kidney will be more, and sometimes it goes so much medial that perforation can occur. In fact, in this case, we have seen that. Tract perforation, the opposite side perforation. This is the opposite side perforation. This is the opposite side perforation. So, but it is small. So, this is the major problem we want to share. So, better to do under dilatation. At the same time, give opposite pressure compression. Especially in children, rectus sheath will be very elastic and the kidney will be very mobile. So, transmission of the movements to the kidney have to be careful. But the stone is cleared. And one more thing is, inferior calyx, a large stone was there like this, but it was easily approachable from the middle calyx. This is the inferior calyceal stone that is pushed into the renal pelvis and then removed. So we want to share that up to 16 to 18 French dilatation can be done. See, this is the inferior calyceal stone, which is present anteriorly. That means it is superficial in terms to the supine PCNL. Then it is held. Actually, we wanted to puncture this calyx, but it was not delineating because entire kidney was occupying the lower calyx. Then these pieces are removed. In terms of the stone clearance, this is very good. But only problem is, while doing dilatation, especially 6 French, 8 French, 9 French dilatation, when you do it, see, all the calyces in supine PCNL could be inspected in this case. Only problem was medial wall, little perforation was there. At the entry only, we could notice it. That might have avoided. In fact, when we did RGP at the end of the study, some amount of the contrast was seen outside the pelvis, which usually heals. Subsequently, we put the nephrostomy for 2 to 3 days and then removed the nephrostomy. And stent also 16 centimeter was looking like a long 2, 2, 2. So we should go for less than that. See, this is a small contrast seen on the medial wall, which is leaked, but was not a problem in the postoperative because rest of the PCS was intact and the nephrostomy is kept in the proper position. So to share, the mobility of the kidney in children in supine PCNL is a concern. Thank you.